Yo, Adam Saxton with Guy in a Cuban. In this video, we're going to look at the new Gateway experience. I've been waiting for this for so long. Let's go check it out. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, the new Gateway Manage experience inside of Power BI, it got a facelift. It's got a new look, a new feel. This is something I've been waiting for a really long time. The old interface that was there, I talked to a lot of customers and they had feedback with regards to, you know, it was really hard to manage and you couldn't filter things in there. And if you had hundreds of gateways or hundreds of data sources, it became unmanageable. And so I'm really happy that we've got the new experience in place. All right, enough of all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and take a look. Okay, so if we are inside of Power BI, you get to it the same way that you've always been able to. So if we go up to the gear up top, we can come down to manage gateways. We will get to a new manage gateway experience. One thing right off the bat, this tripped me up. If you are a tenant admin, this is on by default. I remember getting to this spot and going like, where are my data sources that are defined in the gateway? How else would you do this? That's like the primary reason I go here. Just know that Tenant admin is enabled if you are a Power BI admin or a global admin. So let's turn that off. This is the normal interface for people that are not a Power BI admin or a global admin. So you will see the data sources. You'll also see a list of gateways that you are a part of. And then you'll also see virtual network data gateways if those are configured within your organization. So VNet gateways, that is something that's available as well. So if we go to data sources, you'll see all the data sources here that are configured. You'll also see the gateway that it's registered on. Now, some folks, I've heard some comments, they're like, wow, this shows every data source that I've got out there, and this could be a really long list. How do I manage this? Well, you got the search box up here. If I know the gateway cluster name, I can call admin, and it filters it right away, right? So if I want the data source name, AdventureWorks. Now, all of these other items are also have AdventureWorks inside of them. If I expand it, you'll see here these all have AdventureWorks. We love AdventureWorks here at Guy in a Cube. And so those are things that you can filter down, or if I want to do for a given data source. Let me do file. Those are my file data sources. So I can quickly kind of navigate to these items. So the filtering and searching is really nice inside of here and a very welcomed feature for managing gateways. So within a given data source, if we want to create a new one, we just go up here to new, select the data source gateway cluster that we want, and then we can give it a name. So we can do awesome data source. And we have our data source types that are here, and we can go and actually select those given items. So in this case, maybe I've got a SQL server that's in the mix, and then we can add our server, our database name, our authentication mechanism that we want to do. If it's Windows Auth, Basic Auth, OAuth 2, and then also our settings if we want to enable Kerberos or single sign-on through the gateway and our privacy level. So these are all the normal settings that we had in the old experience. The other thing you can do here is we can go to settings on a given data source and we can edit the credentials for an existing data source that's there. That's cool. Or if we are the owner of it, we can go to manage gateway users or manage the data source users, and we can add other users here that have permissions to use this data source. So that's really nice too. And we can do a spot check and just see, hey, is it online? Sweet. It's working just fine. So it's almost like a test connection. We've got all of our different data sources that are available within the gateways themselves. This is our list of gateways that are installed. If you are the admin of a gateway, you can come in, you can manage the users and add admins to the gateway if you'd like. You can also click on here to see the different gateway nodes within the cluster, and you can disable certain nodes in that cluster, and you can check to see if they're online, what versions they're on, so on and so forth. So this is a really cool feature that was not there in the old UI. So that's really nice. The other thing you can do is you can actually look at the personal gateways. Now, I'm not in the tenant admin role, so it's just going to show the gateways that I have access to, and it's personal. So from my perspective, there can be only one personal gateway and it's there and that's fine. But it'll also show me all the other gateways that I have access to as an individual user, which is nice. If you happen to have items in other data regions, you can change the region here, which is really cool. Now for the tenant administration, same thing. We can see the gateways that are there for the entire tenant, and I'm listed under personal mode. So as a tenant admin, I can see all the personal gateways in my tenant. Be careful. If you haven't looked at this, you may be surprised of how many personal gateways there are in your organization. Just warning. And then if we go back to regular gateways, you'll see these items. The nice thing here is now we have this managed gateway installers. If I'm a tenant admin, I can actually control or restrict or manage who can actually install gateways with inside of my organization. Note that this does not include the restriction or management of personal gateways through the UI. In order to do that, you need to use PowerShell commandlets. I've talked about that in other videos, so you can go check that out. The other thing that's interesting about this is that it has been around for a while now, actually. This is something that's been available in the Power Platform Admin Center, and you'll see that it looks exactly the same, except for the coloring. I know a lot of admins for given Power BI tenants that have been using the Power Platform Admin Center because it gave more rich capabilities than what the managed gateway interface did inside of Power BI. But now the two are the same. What's in the Power Platform Admin Center is what you can interact with from the Power BI portal as well, which is awesome. So I'm excited about the new management experience. I hope you are too, and that you can play around and figure out how everything works inside of here to effectively manage your gateways. All right, I want to hand this over to you. Have you played around with the new management experience? What do you think? What's your favorite thing about it? Do you miss anything in the old experience? Let me know in the comments below. I want to hear it and just give me your thoughts. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.